the idea, and we got it down pat now. At the end you'll see some bloopers about our first attempt on this, which was just a comedy of errors. Bill, we laugh at it later, but boy were we stressing, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, we got this down now. The idea is we have to get the top sheet up very high. This is a very tall trailer. So that's a long ways up. So what we have is, we have a total of 4 2x4s. We have this one here, which we screw to the top of the high sheet. And you'll see it's got some eye bolts in it. See one there and one here. That's to tie a rope to. This board just goes between the two uprights, two screws sticking out, to keep them together. The two uprights are right here. See Bill. And that rope that goes up through that eyelet is what we will attach one end to the eyelets on the board that will screw to the top of the sheet. We'll attach the rope to it, and then we will both, see, we've got two of these uprights. See here? We'll attach the board that's attached to the top of the sheet to a rope, we'll tie a knot, and then we will pull the sheet up. See?
And then we just lean.
And then we just lean the whole thing over, and that holds, then we can adjust it. And that holds our top sheet up while we staple in the bottom all along this line here. See? All right, so let's see how this works out.
Big jump.
All right, so we have this so we can assemble it and disassemble it, because as you'll see in the bloopers, the whole thing is too tall to walk in here with the sheet already attached and everything already hooked up together. And if I was in my new shop, we wouldn't have this problem. So these go, goes on this side.
Okay.
And I don't know if you have that facing the right way or not.
But we'll find out here.
We'll find out in a minute. Comedy of errors.
I think this is right.
You can tell by the offset.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. Okay, so let me get this side in first.
Good.
I got it. So we assemble this thing in the building, in the shelter. Let me get the other one first. It's only a few screws, so it doesn't take long. Believe me, everything else takes much longer. These are deck screws. I really like them. So now we'll go ahead and lean this back in preparation to hook up our sheet. So now we're going to go screw the longboard into the top of the high sheet. All right, so now we're going to go ahead. This is the lifting board. Remember, these sheets are almost 16 feet long. It's a big trailer. We want a little bit hanging out on each side. On each end. Go ahead and lay it down. It goes this way. With the hooks out that way. Okay, let me just set it there for a second.
I have nothing hanging.
Well, I know, but you're holding on to it, see?
Well.
So just hold on to it for a minute. Okay, now, your way, so you got about 3 inches, is that good?
That looks about like 3 there.
Okay.
Now, do you want it flush with the metal on top of it?
Might as well.
Yeah, okay.
Why do anything else? Remember, there's only 2 of us. I've heard of some of my viewers having a problem with 12 and 13 foot sheets. 11-foot sheets and with three people. So this kind of alleviates all that.
Well, who are all those people running by the camera?
Yeah. So you're going to have to back out that way and then come back this way. Yeah, so that it can go in that way.
Right. Well,
why don't we just... want to get on this edge, on this end, like I was yesterday on the back end. So you get over there.
Hell, we could, I could just pick this up, maybe, and just go out that way.
Might be able to. Yeah, whatever's easiest. This is a heavy 030 metal, remember. Oh yeah, that works great, okay. All right, so in we go. And we're gonna set it down, I'm gonna move the camera. Watch the curl. Watching the curl.
Riding the curl. Riding the curl.
Only we'd have known the other day.
Are we going to be okay like this?
Well, I think we're going to have to tie it first. So, you'll just, you can just hold it for
a minute. Yeah, I can hold this and you can tie that off. And...
yeah, I'll tie that off. So now you can see these are both leaned over. We have the ropes attached. See? We have the ropes attached and tied off on that cross beam. See up there? See how this is? Give yourself plenty of rope. I keep shortening up on the rope, but give yourself plenty of rope. Now we're just going to lift it. Get it into place. We want the bottom edge to be right along the bottom of this board that goes all the way the length of the trailer. So to recap, we have the lifter board on the face of the metal, screwed in from behind. And remember, this metal is going to, the top of the trailer is only goes to about here. So, you know, this board is actually way above that. That's the way they usually are. You have 8 feet worth of metal with both sheets and less than 8 feet on the trailer. And this thing is in place, ready to lift. We just pull on those ropes. And then we have a hook down here to tie off from. We can either tie off here or we can tie off like that, whichever is most convenient at the time.
Go for it.
Do we want to pull this back?
No.
Just lift it the way we are?
I think so. What do you, well, we could. Let's untie it first.
Yeah.
It's only the second time we've done this, folks, so it's not perfected yet. We're still experimenting. So we're going to lean this whole thing back first out of our way. We have to because this we can't get this past anymore. So lean the whole thing back, just like that. Okay. Now, yeah, just kind of put your leg against it.
Yeah, it's sitting on my shoe.
Well, lift it. Yeah, you have to lift with your hands on the board, remember? Yeah, so get it up as high as you can.
I'll hold it. Are we going in with it?
No. Keep it over here. Just put your knee on it like this, or your leg, okay? Grab it with both hands.
Don't want my neck anywhere near that shit.
Yeah. Okay, I think that's high enough for now.
Yeah.
So let's, while we're holding it, let's lean it over. Okay, slowly. Yeah, now let's see where we're at. Okay, we're a little low.
I'm that's a little my low. High. I'm, oh.
And you push, oh, I'm way high. Okay.
Yeah, you're way high. I gotta come down.
Okay, and I don't want to leave an eighth of an inch this time. I want it even with the bottom of this board. There, right there.
I can come down a little.
No, not that board. These boards. Go up just a hair. I think you're actually right there, so.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, hold it right there.
Oh, okay. I see what you mean. This board might be different than those.
And my cell phone decides to ring now, of course. All right, so at any rate, I'm gonna tie off.
Okay, go ahead, you tie off, I got this.
And I know who's calling me. It's Vintage Trailer Supply.
To tell you.
Perfect timing, Matt. Perfect timing. I hope you see this video. You'll see why I didn't answer. And what I want to do is go around once with a wrap.
Really secure it, yeah.
Yeah, so.
You know what?
This rope is very frictional. Frictional?
Frictitious.
Yeah, so it's not going to slip very easily, and that's a good thing. That's why I use this. Neoprene or whatever it is.
Here, grab it from that side.
Yeah. I got it. Now, let's get this one where we want it.
Up a little higher, so lift. What am I?
No, you went up. You went up. Go again.
Right there. Hold it right there for right now. Now we can adjust it by hand as long as it's not too high. We can also move these legs to adjust it up and down. It's the best way to do it. So we get it where we want it first. Okay, you can get out of the way now so they can see what I'm doing here. So you see, I got it going through this loop and then I wrap it around this way. We got plenty of friction, so that's not going to go anywhere. Tie this off. And then by moving the legs towards the trailer or back from the trailer, we can raise and lower this thing a little bit for adjustment.
Pretty fancy, huh, folks?
He's going in to get some staples that we left in there. Okay, so you can see we got it up there. All right. And I've adjusted the height by moving this leg in or out so that now our seam is right where we want it at the bottom of this board. And I'm going to start shooting some staples in it to hold it up. I'll put some staples in this end, and then I'll go down here and put some staples in this end. I'm holding it, Bill.
All right.
Okay. And I get out of the way. Because we want it level with that board there. So we're good. All right. Okay. I'm using half inch staples just to line everything up, and then we'll go to 3/4. So I need to come down just a hair. So I'm going to move this leg here out just a bit. Let's see, I'm a little high. There it is. That's where I want to be. Start at the door, but let me just make sure we're still on here where we want to be. Where's that thing ends right here? Yeah, perfect. Now we have wires that we have to drill for and pull out up near the top. Now remember, don't forget your wires. All right, so that's out. Now we got another one over there that we have to do, but I want to get the bottom staples in here first. But we have another wire for the running lights up in the top corner. I go about 3 inches apart. Sure not going through. Watch for orange. That means a wire is there, which we don't have any. But remember, we did that. I'm going to go about 5 inches apart, I think, on these. So the height is 1 inch below this brake, okay, and the distance from the end to this wire is 12 and 3 quarters. So I marked it already, I'm just double checking. So, yeah. Now I marked it a quarter too long, so I'm going back a quarter. Need to dimple your metal or the thing will run all over the place. Okay, would you hand me the drill, please? Bill's multitasking.
Very multi.
Pull it away so it doesn't hurt the wire. It's running the wrong speed, of course. Everything goes wrong when you film. Here's the gun. Run the wires through. It's actually just one wire. This is for a running light. There we go. Our wire is run. All right, so now we're just going to finish stapling around. And what we do for that is I take a real small drill, less than an eighth of an inch, and I drill holes where I want to put staples, right next to the framing, the outside of the framing. And then I put staples in a quarter inch. So I'm going to do that all the way around now. I'll show you a couple, and then we do it all the way around. Then we can dismantle our lift system. All right, so like I say, can you see this? Get up close, Bill. I usually do it on the brakes, because you want to staple on the brakes. You don't want to staple in between the brakes, because it'll make a big dimple that you will be able to see later. So keep your fingers out of the way. You don't want to drill through your finger when you go through this side. So you see, you do that. It makes a little mess of the framing sometimes. You do that. You do a bunch of them. Like I usually go about every two breaks, every second break, second or third, because you don't need too many staples, because remember the fold over and the J-rail is going to hold everything securely in the end, you know. And then we just go in a quarter inch from that hole. Shoot a staple. We'll do that all the way around about every third break, and then we'll be able to take down our lift system. Screw the metal. Come here and get the shot here. See, we got to unscrew the metal from the lifter board, is what I'm calling that. So I want to go along and undo all those screws. We don't have to worry about it falling because it's tied up there, remember? With that rope.
Safety first.
I was trying to tell Bill, but he wouldn't listen to me.
Safety first.
Just kidding. He was trying to tell me. So where's that screw? It's right there. So, wrong speed. So I'm going to undo these. There's only four of them. Put them in my pocket. Next one is way down there. Out there. Now I'm going to refine this system when I get into my shock. I'm going to get it so I can do this by myself, because Bill doesn't want to move.
And fly my hang glider and paraglider and rock climb.
In the same place every single day, which I think would be terribly boring after a while.
My nickname's Barstow Billy, because I flew from Elsinore to Barstow.
Yeah, big deal.
It's only two people ever done it. They're both named Bill.
I would like to hear everybody's comments on whether Bill should move to Nevada with me so that we can keep him in the videos.
More money.
They weren't going to come out.
So leave it in the comments. Do you think Bill should move with me to Nevada so he can keep working with me?
What?
I mean, he's been flying Elsinore for how many years now? 30-something?
Yeah.
He could get old.
I just turned the different direction. I go left for 10 years, then I turn right for 10.
Get in there.
All right, go ahead. You see, we just moved that back and away from it.
Ta-da.
That's a done deal.
Voila, ta-da.
So the metal is up there. And wires are sticking through. Bottom is nailed along the seam lock, the S-lock.
Screws.
Yeah, we gotta take two screws out. See, now we always put a screw in each end just for protection. Make sure this thing ain't gonna fall, because sometimes staples can give way. But we'll take these two screws out. There's one in each end.
Yeah.
If Billy ever gets the screw gun. So we'll take that one out, take the other one out. You didn't watch your eye.
Oh.
You could have ripped your eye out.
I can't find my head.
Folks, you have to be really careful of these corners. These are very sharp, and it's very easy to rip your eye out. They're always at eye level. So, very dangerous. So that's it. The high sheet is hung perfectly. Now, of course, I got to route out the door. And I'll get into all that later. I don't have time right now because I'm under the gun deadline. Got to be completely moved out of here by a certain time, and I got to get this done. So you're not going to see me put the bottom sheet in. I just don't have time. But you can see that in the 59 Shasta installation of the lower metal. And you see me routing out the wheel well and other things. That's in trailer tidbits and tutorials. So you can see there on how you just slip the bottom sheet in after you cut it. You just slip it in here. It's got an auto mold that goes along the bottom. I think I talked about that before. And so you have to measure from the bottom at both ends, from the bottom down here up into this right there. See, up into this S-lock. So I always give myself an eighth of an inch slop right there. I give myself an eighth of an inch slop. Up or down. So this thing is a full 5/8 of an inch. So you have 5/8 of an inch that it can move around, but you want to be up in there as far as possible. But the bottom has to come up tight against there. So I'm sorry I don't have time to show you us doing that, but we have to get this done today. And you know, I make mistakes when I'm using the camera, and plus it takes time to set up the shots. I was lucky to be able to get this done for you. So this is Larry from CanhamTrailers.com, Mobile Tech, signing off for today.
Groundhog Day.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's Groundhog Day. Okay. Mobile Tech, signing off for today.
Groundhog Day.
Mobile Tech, signing off for today.
Groundhog Day.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's Groundhog Day. Okay. Keep on trailering.
Are you a groundhog?
Do it again. Groundhog Day.
Did anybody mention it's Groundhog Day?
That was a good movie.
Yeah, it was. It's probably going to be on tonight.
Yeah. All right. Today went much better. We got both these pieces up in one day. Remember, I only have 5-hour work days, because I can't start till 10 o'clock and it's winter, so sun goes down early. But we're not going to cut any windows out because it's going to travel up north first. I am going to put some screws in the skin. They're going to go there anyway. And there will be some staples around where the windows are and stuff to hold it, because I don't want the skin to be flapping in the wind. The door will be in it also. But it came out really nice. Didn't it come out nice?
Nice. Very nice.
So, real happy with it. The router worked good. I wish I could have shown you that stuff, but we just don't have the time. You'll see it later. There'll be more videos, and you'll see all that. But we just did not have the time right now. I'm under the gun. So I don't like deadlines. A reasonable deadline is okay, but when somebody says, on this day, you have to be gone, you know.
Or else.
Yeah. But what I really like about new skin, you don't see this too often. You can see we have no seam down here under the door, and we have no seam over the door. It's one big long piece of skin, and then you router it out. And yeah, it burnt this wood up a little bit, but you know, there's metal that wraps all the way around here to there.
That was the only thing, the seam right there.
Yeah, the seam made it slow down, so it burned a little bit. But it's no big deal. That, you know, most of that is covered with metal, you know, from the jam. And then down here we got a threshold, and up there we got a header. So it's fine. It's really neat. I'm loving this trailer. I'm falling in love with it now.
Groundhog Day.
Groundhog Day.
Groundhog Day.
Groundhog Day.
Groundhog Day. Did anybody mention it's Groundhog Day?
All right, you can't see us pick it up, but we're just going to stand it up. See it over there? We're just going to stand it up, and then we're going to carefully walk in with it and put it up against the trailer. Wait, we're going to stand it up all the way.
I can't.
Get behind it like me. And kind of, yeah, there you go.
I'm afraid you're sinking it, right?
Keep going. Okay, now you have to, while you're holding it, you have to climb down.
It ain't gonna happen.
Lift it up. From underneath, like you were doing. So like you were doing.
I got the 2x4.
Okay, pick it up. And straight up.
I got, don't move.
Okay.
Okay, I got it.
All right. Straight up. Don't move it. All right, that would have been fun to watch on video.
Okay, don't
now hold it. On to it. Before you move, I gotta get this one straight. Okay. Now I can kind of hold it.
Got it?
Not the whole thing. You'll have to hold it too. Okay. Now, gotta keep that board straight up and down.
Slowly go.
Yeah. You gotta hold it like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, like this.
You're gonna lose it, let me know.
No, I got it.
Okay.